The ActiveState Platform is a universal package management solution for Python, Perl, and TCL. Today, I'm going to show you how to use it to create a Python 3.9 environment and then install and manage it with our state tool, CLI. So the easiest way to get started is just to click on Set Up a New Runtime. And I'm going to choose Python. It's going to be a custom build. We're going to use version 3.9. One of the new features we have is the ability to add bundles, which really just means you're adding more packages all at one time. So I'm going to go ahead and choose this Python module build support bundle. And I'm going to build this for Windows. And what we're going to do is create a Twitter bot. So this is going to be something where I can just enter something in Slack and have it immediately posted to Twitter. So if I click my Create Runtime, I see that I've got this configuration going. It's Python 3.9, its platform is Windows. It has a few packages already, that module support one we had, plus a few others that are necessary for Python itself or for the operating system. Now, if I had a requirements.txt for my Twitter bot, I could go ahead and paste the contents here. Since I don't, I can add manually bundles, like that Win32 one we had before, or I could just add them one at a time. So I'm going to need something like Python Twitter, so I can access Twitter. Let's go ahead and add that. I'm going to need something like Slack Bolt, which will allow me to connect to Slack. There we go. And I'm going to need something like Flask, because I'm going to have to stand this up as a service. And there we go. So now I've added three more packages, and the platform is resolving the dependencies. You can see everything highlighted in green is the dependencies we pulled in for these three packages I've added. And now I can go ahead and build this by clicking commit. Go over to the download builds tab. And you can see it's already built. So very quickly, 23 packages all built in parallel for me. Now, if I want to install this, I can just go ahead and click on the install script. I'm going to move over to my Windows machine, and I can just paste that on the command line here. You can see it's going to install the state tool for me. It's already installed, and it wants to activate my virtual environment. So we're going to install this Twitter bot project into a virtual environment. It's downloading from the ActiveState platform now all the dependencies, all the packages we need. And it's downloading and installing Python 3.9 as well. All this goes into a virtual environment, so I don't have to worry about stepping on any other installations I have. And there you have it. I'm ready to go. So very quickly, I've got it set up and running. If I just do state packages, for example, can see the packages I've got installed, Flask, Python, Twitter, and Slack Bolt. Now, if I wanted to, say, not use Flask, maybe I want to use Django instead. So what I could do is I could do a state search, and we'll search our catalog to see if we have Django. Looks like we have a lot of versions of it. So I'm going to go ahead and say state install Django, and we'll let the ActiveState platform figure out which version is best. It'll go ahead and grab all of the dependencies that Django needs, and it'll install them locally. If I go ahead and do state packages again, you can see I now have Django installed as well. So that's the way to use our state tool CLI to manage your environment after you've created and downloaded it. And now I'm ready to go ahead and start working on my project.